looking after if a typical state table or a state flow graph is given or state graph is given, how to solve it, how to reduce it first of all. So first thing, in this numerical we have given certain states, that is A to E. Okay, that is A, B, C, D and E. Okay, total 5 states were given, and the followed next states were given, that is B, C, B, D, B, A, E, C, and then followed by B, D. So these are certain states that were given. See, we have its next states as B, C, B, D, B, A, E, C and B, D. Okay, E, C and B, D. So we have certain next states which are very common in this table that we have to identify. Okay, but before that we should start how to reduce the number of states by the procedure that was already discussed in the previous sessions, like the certain steps. Okay, and each state, okay, each present state is giving certain set of outputs, certain set of outputs. This is the table, generally they give it in any typical examination. Okay, so first thing is you have to reduce the number of redundant or equivalent states. Okay, first we have to reduce this. We start from A, which is the present state, then we'll start comparing with each other so that it will be easy to understand. A is giving the next states as BC. Is there any BC here? No, we have to skip it. B is giving next states as BD. Is there any other state that is giving BD? We have to find out. E is giving BD. Okay, B and E are almost the same. So we have B, which is giving two next states as BD, is equivalent to E, which is also giving a common state, which is BD. Okay, so these two are redundant states, right? These two are redundant states. So B is done. We have to go with C. Is C is giving BA? Is there any state that is there any present state that is giving next state as BA? No. Okay, it is. It should not be changed. Then D is providing a state as E, next state as EC. Is the state the same thing for any other present states? No. E is giving, already it is done. Okay. So here, after this, once this states are equivalent states are compared. Okay. So we have to compare the present state, compare with the other states for the redundancy. Right. This is what we have done. Then here we have equivalent states in our condition, which is B and E, we have identified. Okay, so what is their respective outputs? Outputs are also the same. So these two states can be removed, or one state we have to retain. Okay, first state is giving B, so B is found in most of the conditions, so we have to keep B as such. Okay, we should not touch. E is the state which has to be removed, which is a redundant state, right? So now we will remove the thing and we will rewrite the table as it is. Okay, so replace E by B. Okay, replace E by B and then remove the state E. Now there is no equivalent state to reduce in the table, so the table will become like this. Now we will move on to the next part, which is if a state diagram is given. Okay, if a state diagram is given, how to convert the state diagram into table, and then how to reduce it, how to redraw the state diagram or a state flow graph. Okay, here we can see this, in this state diagram we can see A is giving two outputs, or the next states of A are D and B. Similarly for B, the next state is, look at this arrow graph, arrow will define the next state. Okay, arrow will define the next state. B is giving two next states, which is E and C. Okay, C is providing one state and it is a self state also. Okay, self state also. The next state of C is also C. Okay, based on the inputs and outputs. C is providing D and C. Similarly, D is providing one output, which is B. And D is, again, it is also the next state for itself. Look at this arrow, which is turning, which is a curve. Similarly, E is providing two next state, which one is C, other one is A, based on its inputs and outputs. Okay, let us start drawing the table out of this. How many states we have? A, B, C, D and E. Okay, let us make out, let us check the number of states. Okay, let us check the number of states and then we'll start with the other part. So here A is the current state. Let us say current state BA is offering two states, that is one is D, other one is B. Okay, if similarly we have another state B which is giving two next states as C and E. Okay, which is C and E, right? Similarly, we have C which is offering two states, the current state itself as well as the next state as D. Okay, you can write D and C, right? Based on its inputs and outputs, we have to shuffle it. Okay, how the position is, let us check that while we are making up the table. So similarly, we have D which is offering two next states, that is D itself, another one is B. Okay, similarly E is offering two next states, which is A and C. Okay, this is the next state's condition based on its current states. Okay, similarly, how to mention their respective outputs? So first we have to make the current states as A to E, followed by we have to make the next states based on its inputs. If x is equal to 1, what is the state? X is equal to 0, because here it is very clearly given. If A is having 1 as input, it would give D. Okay, if A is having 1 as input or x is equal to 1, it will give D. Similarly, if it is 0, it is offering B. Okay, it is offering B. So the output is also 0, output here also it is 0. So mention the outputs respectively. So it is offering x is equal to 0, which is B, x is equal to 1, it is D. If x is equal to 0, that is for B, it is giving 0 output. For x is equal to 1, that is D, it is offering 0. Similar way, you have to mention for B. So B has two states. If it is equal to 1, it is offering C. If it is equal to 0, it is offering E. Okay. So please have a look. If it is equal to 0, it is offering E. If it is equal to 1, it is offering C. Similarly, its output. Okay, look, let us check the output. For B to C transition, we got output as 1. Okay. For B to E transition, we got output as 0. Okay, the same thing I have mentioned. Okay, similarly, you do it for the rest of the conditions. Okay, rest of the conditions. After this, we have to find out the redundant states. Okay, let us start making up the redundant states. So let us check for A. Do we have anything called as BD? Yes, we have a BD at D. Okay, which is B and D, which is equivalent to its A present state. So eliminate D. Similarly, B is offering E and C. E and C. Is there any E and C? No, it is not there. So you have to keep it as such. Similarly, C is offering D and C. Do we have any D and C? No, it is not there. So keep it as such. So D is already a removed state. E is offering A and C. Do we have any A and C? No, it is not there. So keep it as such. Reframe the table or rewrite the table in its reduced form. Okay. This is what I have done. That is A, B, D is removed, C and E are there. Okay. D has been removed because it's the next state. Okay, later state. So you remove the later state. Right? So now we have to reform the condition or reform the diagram, that is the state diagram. Here, what condition has been removed? D. Okay, completely D is removed. This part is removed. Which and all next states will get removed? A to D will get removed. A to C will get removed. Similarly, D is offering one input to B also. That also will get removed. Okay, so let us reframe this. So A is forming a state which is B. Okay, let us check. B, A is offering a state which is B and A. Here, why it is A? Because D is connected with A. D is directly connected with A. Okay, what is the previous state for this B, which is A? So you have to make it in such a way that D will not come in any of the conditions, right? Similarly, in the previous case, it is EC. It is okay. DC is coming. Okay, DC is coming. Instead of D, it should be A. Replace D with A. That's what we have done. So since D is removed, A state is there. So replace everything with a A. Right. So like this, we have to form the diagram. Okay, let us check for the next conditions also. That is AC. We got AC. Similarly, E is offering BC. In the previous case, E is offering AC. Okay, AC, A and C. So write it as such. Okay. So no change here. So write it as it is. Right. Now, is there any further reduction possible? If further reduction goes on, then we have to remove A. That should not be done. Okay. This is the limit. Right. Because the combinations and permutations will go off. So don't write further. So now B is offering EC, C is offering two next states which is AC, and E is also offering two next state which is AC, because last state will again continues. Okay. So let us check drawing the diagram for this, or the state diagram for this. A is offering two state. First state is, which state it is offering? B and A itself. Okay, B and A itself. So make it A itself. Okay, which is 1 by 0, and for 0 by 0 it is offering B. Now let us check what B is offering. E and C. B is offering E and C. E, what is the condition? E is, if it is output is X is equal to 0, it will offer E. If output is 1, it will offer C. Okay. So if the output is 0, input for input is 0, it is offering E. Okay. For the next state, which is 0 and 1. Okay, look at this 1. So for the next state, which is 1 by 1, if it is offering 1 comma 1, it is offering C. Okay. Similarly, C is offering AC. So C is offering AC. So we have to check for what, which condition. For if X is equal to 0, it is offering C itself. Okay. For X is equal to 0, it is offering A. Okay. And X is equal to 0 at the output also. So that is, the condition is 0 by 0. When it is offering E, when it is offering, if the condition is 1, input is 1, output is 0. Okay. Input is 1, output is 0. Right. But what is the thing? It is not offering E, I suppose. It is offering C itself. Okay. For C itself, it is 1 comma 0, 1 by 0. Okay. Right. Look at the next condition, which is C is done. E is offering A when it is 0 by, what is the output? 1. It is offering C when it is 1 by 1. Okay, the output is also 1. When it is 1 by 1, it is offering C. Okay, output and input both are 1. So the diagram would look something like this. It is also given here. Right, for your reference. So after reduction, only you have to draw this diagram. In the question, it might be given like this. So you have to follow step by step. Okay, first convert this thing into the state table. After converting this into state table, you just reduce it based on the redundant states. After redundant states, you have to make this reduced state diagram.